What's up, Wavy Mob? It's your girl Tori, and I'm back with another video. What's up, y'all? I'm back with another video. I'm here with a snack bag. You know what I'm saying? I ain't really in the mood to eat no whole meal. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna get a snack. So I'm gonna do a snack bang and a story time at the same time. Yeah. Right. So yeah. So anyway. So I got, yo, for one, I appreciate everybody for giving me story time ideas. Y'all got some really, really good ideas in. So I got a lot of story times coming to y'all. Things I didn't even think y'all wanted to know. You know what I'm saying? I'm ready to tell, you know what I'm saying? So the first story time of today is my first girlfriend. So my first girlfriend, boy, my first girlfriend, I was with my first girlfriend for like damn near three years. It was probably about two and a half, about to go to three. Didn't make it to three. Well, at least we got that far, shit. But yeah, man, like my first girl, we were friends. Like we were, I mean, we're still friends. I don't know. Let me rephrase that. We're still friends, but you know, we got our, you know, our own lives. You know, she do her thing, I'm doing my thing. You know? But this was back in high school. I think I was what, in the 10th grade? She was a year before, well, yeah, a year older than me. So she graduated before I did. So we dated throughout, you know, high school or whatever. And we played basketball together too. So it was just like, we was always around each other. Summer camps, we were there. She was over my house, I was over her house. We all hung out together, we all hung out together. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's just the type of crew we used to have as far as basketball. You know what I'm saying? Well, everybody was around everybody all the time. But with her, like, you know what I'm saying? I can say that was one of my best and healthy relationships that I've been in. You know what I'm saying? You know, and the fact that it lasted that long. Like I said, you know, shit, nowadays you can't even get past 6 months with motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? But that was that old puppy love, high school, you know what I'm saying? Love. And it's just like, you know, shit, it's crazy how life turns out, you know? And she was dope though. Like I said, she was on the basketball team. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to think, did she play something else? I can't think right now. I don't think she played, but she had to. Cause she was like the all around sports athlete. You know what I'm saying? Like she was, it's anything that had to do with sports, she had something to do with it. Like I think her recent job right now, she's a referee. She's a basketball referee. And I think she might referee like recs and stuff, but she referee like the ACC games and all that. So yeah, she's doing pretty good. She's doing good. You know what I'm saying? We still keep in contact. We still fight each other on social media. No hard feelings, no bad feelings. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, I feel like that was probably one of the best relationships I was in. But you gotta think for the time and the age that we were, of course, you know, the problems that you would have now in your adult, in my adult relationship, that wasn't even an issue back then. You know what I'm saying? So it's just crazy how shit changed, man. Just looking back on all the people that I dated in the past, man. Some have been good, some have been bad. But you know what? I learned something from every last one of those situations. And honestly, I don't have any beef with any ex. You know what I'm saying? I'm pretty cool with, you know what I'm saying, majority of my exes. The only, I could probably count maybe like two ex that I probably don't talk to or have anything to do with. But anybody else, like we cool. They can, you know what I'm saying, hit me up, say what's up, you know what I'm saying, not be that and there, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't like in relationships on bad terms. I think it's just, it's pointless because it's just like unnecessary hate towards this person or unnecessary hard feelings towards this person when you could just be focused on something else. You know what I'm saying? What's me being mad at you gonna do for me? Nothing. You know what I'm saying? And you over there living your life and I'm mad at you? No. So I never been, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, I can only name like two ex that I really don't talk to. You know what I'm saying? But if it was up to me, any relationship or anybody that I'm even talking to and not in a relationship, it's always better, you know what I'm saying, to end things on a good term, end things. You know what I'm saying? So there ain't no tension. Anybody ain't trying to, 10 years later, somebody coming back for revenge or some shit. Like, people do that shit. Like, people sit around and wait to get you back. Like, that shit is crazy to me. You know what I'm saying? But there's no bad karma, period. You know what I'm saying? You already got to deal with the day-to-day life of life being life. So I just feel like that extra energy can go to something else. You know what I'm saying? So, and then I see somebody else, they asked me, what was my first heartbreak? And to be honest, my first girlfriend was my first heartbreak. Because it's like, we didn't end on, we were going head to head, because that's any relationship. When you've been together for a long time and it's just like, you know, like both sides know, like, yo, this shit's running out. You know what I'm saying? Like, shit is getting real and I'm over it. You know what I'm saying? So that was more of our situation. And then the fact that, I don't know, I think back then I wasn't really ready to let go of her. You know what I'm saying? Because she was all I knew for like years. You know what I'm saying? So I don't think I was, ready to let go. And I think I was really hurt, you know what I'm saying, when me and her broke up, you know what I'm saying, at the time. It's like, of course it don't affect me now, but back then it affected me. Because it's like, yo, I've been with you for 2 years and such and such and such. And it's like, now the shit not working no more. What the fuck going on? You know what I'm saying? What the fuck? You know? What the fuck? But anyway. Well, yeah. She started dating somebody in our circle, so that was an issue. You know what I'm saying? So it was just like, it's just funny thinking back on high school shit. It's like nowadays you be like, okay, it ain't even that deep. But back then you made it like so, like such a big deal, and it really fucking wasn't. But yeah, man, like I don't know. Like I said, well, I had a first boyfriend too. I had a first boy. It was before my first girlfriend, of course. So I was dating him in middle school. And me and him are still cool to this day. He found out that I was dating women, he got mad at me and stopped talking to me for about a year. He did. He was really, really upset with me. Why? I don't know. But he was really upset with me. But then he came around, you know what I'm saying? We still cool. We cool now, you know what I'm saying? See, with him, I was with him for 3 years in middle school. But like I said, that's middle school. That ain't for real, for real. You know what I'm saying? But everybody thought me and him was gonna get married. But that's how cool we was. We didn't have sex. We didn't, you know what I'm saying? We didn't do what normal relationships do. You know what I'm saying? But that was like my homie. You know what I'm saying? But I don't know, man. Every first, you know what I'm saying? I, you know what? It's good to go through heartbreak, I feel like. You know what I'm saying? Because you know how to, because you got to think, it's different people out here in the world. You know what I'm saying? Everybody go through things differently. Everybody deals with things differently. You know what I'm saying? But there's a lot of people out here that really can't take breakup or take rejection. Like me, I'm not a rejection type of person. Like, that's why I don't even ask. Don't tell me no. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy and it's delusional as that sounds. That's just how I am. Like, I don't like the word no. I don't. Period. You know what I'm saying? But I feel like everybody should go through breakups so they can know how it feels and know how to mentally prepare themselves, you know, if it happens again. You know what I'm saying? Because one breakup ain't the last breakup. You know what I'm saying? It's just life. You go through it. This is Ginger Ale, by the way. But yeah, this is fun though. Going back, you know what I'm saying, to the past, you know, thinking about the past is funny because it brings up a lot of memories. And the questions that y'all put up for me to answer, well, tell a story time about, was really, really good. So yeah. But yeah, man, I hope y'all enjoyed this, man. Hey, if you have any questions about this story time, make sure y'all, you know, comment down below. Let me know what y'all want to know. And yeah, man, y'all have a blessed day. I got more videos to do, baby mom. I got to go. I love y'all. I'm out.